Sun in the sky, you know how it feels.
Hi everyone. I'm here with Bobo, my bear. Give him a wave. And I've got my book, Christopher Nibble, to share with you today. Are you ready? I love this story. It starts here. Look at all the guinea pigs. So, if there was one thing, sorry, Bobo can't see, I'll see him over there. If there was one thing Christopher Nibble loved more than football, it was eating dandelion leaves. He ate dandelion leaves at breakfast time, at lunch time, and at dinner time. And if Christopher felt peckish between meals, he ate dandelion leaves. But it wasn't just Christopher who liked dandelion leaves. Mr. and Mrs. Nibble liked them. His sister liked them. His friends liked them. In fact, every guinea pig in Danderville loved dandelion leaves. Munch, munch, nibble, munch, nibble. All day long, the happy sound of munching and nibbling filled the air. Until, that is, dandelion leaves began to run out. Dandelion dishes were taken off the menus, and dandelion drinks disappeared from the shelves. Menu today, carrot and lettuce wrap on a bed of, not dandelion leaves, cabbage leaves. Not dandelion soup, cabbage soup. Not dandelion and broccoli quiche, cabbage and broccoli quiche. The last few leaves could be bought on the internet for a huge amount of money. Soon, the worst thing imaginable happened. All over the town, the dandelions had been munched to nothing more than bitten down stalks, and the guinea pigs had to make do with chewy cabbage instead. Just one dandelion was left, but nobody knew about it except Christopher Nibble. It happened to be growing right outside his bedroom window. Christopher's mouth watered at the sight of it, but he knew he mustn't eat it or let anyone else eat it, not if it was the last dandelion in town. It might even be the last dandelion in the whole world. He thought hard and decided to go to the library. He borrowed a book called Everything You Need to Know About Dandelions, and he read it very carefully. He found a little cloche to protect the dandelion, and every day he watered it and he picked off the bugs. Every day he was very good about not taking even the tiniest little nibble, while he waited and waited and waited. Until finally, his dandelion had grown the most beautiful white head of seeds. Very gently, Christopher picked it and carried it all the way up Daisy Chain Hill. When he reached the top, he had just enough puff to take a deep breath and blow. Wow. The seeds filled the air and landed gently all over Danderville. At first, nobody noticed, but soon the new plants started to sprout fresh leaves. And in no time at all, Danderville was filled with the happy sound of munching once more. As for Christopher, he still loves playing football. Nibble, munch, nibble. But now there's something he loves just as much as eating dandelions. Christopher loves growing them. What a clever Christopher Nibble. Now, Bobo, did you like the story? Oh, yes, he says he did. Bye-bye for now. See you again for another story time.